Yeah, here we are. Looks like it was working.
So, now,
I want to do this video on how to feel good moment by moment. Well, here's an example. I was at a church yesterday expecting them to be serving food at 5:45 p.m. on Monday. I went there and they weren't. And there was a lady there who just pulled up in the car. So I was just sitting there at the back door, looking through the glass door into the hallway of the church and waiting to see if someone might show up. Then I see someone through the other side of the building, down the hallway, through the front doors of the glass. I see some people down there in a van outside, and they're moving some furniture. And then the lady, of course, I'm in the back part of the building, and they have other buildings back there, so the lady drives up, and she finally gets out of the car, and she's kind of concerned, you know, because she's a churchgoer. And I look like a streeter dude because I'm wearing my streeter clothes that are all dirty. And she's all concerned, and so I could sense it, you know, how church people are when streeter people are around their churches. They get uncomfortable. And so she asked me, you know, can I help you? And I says, yeah, you know, I'm here to, well, first of all, I'm sitting there, you know, as I'm looking into the glass of the hallway. This is getting to the feelings of how to feel good. And I'm kind of just waiting there and feeling it out. And my feelings are telling me, okay, well, I can sense that this woman's uncomfortable. I could feel it. But also at the same time, that was my own projection. So I was creating my own reality at that time, too. I just wasn't aware of it. Because in my own mind, I was projecting that she was going to be uncomfortable. So that was my own fault right there. But getting back to my feelings, topic of this video, you know, how to feel good moment by moment. So I'm just sitting there and I'm thinking, you know, well, she'll be out of the car in the next 10, 15 seconds. I just decided to sit there for 15 seconds. Okay. Now, if you know anything about feelings, 15 seconds is a long time to be sitting with a feeling, isn't it? Especially if the feeling is one of panic, fear, confusion, instability, wonderment. You know, like, I wonder what's going to happen. As opposed to, you know, feeling totally relaxed, like you're sitting on your own couch at home watching TV or something, you know, you've got a care in the world, you're feeling so damn good, you don't even realize you're feeling good, you just are feeling good because you got some Snickers bars beside you, you have a coffee or a Coke, your favorite beverage, you name it. Get real with yourself because you, if you know you're home alone, no one else is around, you're jacking your shit. If you're feeling like it, so getting back to the, you know, the 15, I'm sitting there 15 seconds waiting for this lady to get out of the car. And so getting to my feelings, I'm thinking to myself within those 15 seconds, well, should I just wait here for her to get out of the car so I can ask her the question, you know, are they going to be serving dinner tonight? Or should I, you know, feel scared and feel intrusive? Like, since how there's no one around, obviously they're not having dinner. There's no cars around. There's no people around. The doors aren't open. You know, I should feel panicky and scared, like, you know, I'm trespassing. Because after all, there's no church hours going on right now. And so that can be considered trespassing. But that's all a matter of commercial lien, as far as that's concerned. Another subject. But, you know, I'm sitting there and I'm thinking to myself, I was really kind of unconsciously, without even thinking about it, I was trying to, for that 15 seconds, trying to figure out what would be the best feeling thing to do in the moment. And so I unconsciously, without even thinking about this, because I'm looking at this from a perspective of it already happening, and so I'm looking back and analyzing everything that went on. But my feeling was one of a path of moment by moment. When I mean moment by moment, I'm talking thought by thought, or instant by instant, frame by frame, second by second. I could even go down to that. 15 seconds is 15 different thoughts that could happen. 15 different scenarios running through the mind that can happen. But overall, looking back at it, my path was one of searching for what's going to make me feel good right here in this moment of these 15 seconds. And so I realized that my expectation was fueling my feeling, because I was feeling pretty much at ease, because I was in a state of waiting for her to get out of the car. And so I felt very good to be able to just sit there and wait. As I did, I just kind of sat on my bike. I had my foot on the ground. I was sitting on the seat of the bike. And I would just kind of face toward the building. But I was more or less, the building was 12 o'clock if I was to look straight onto it. But I was looking more or less, had my bike angled at 2 o'clock. And she was sitting down there around 5 o'clock. And so, you know, I had my my gaze and my view looking toward 2 o'clock. But yet I was sensitive, waiting for her to get out of the car. Running the car door, listening for the car door to open. And then she finally got out, you know. But my point is, for those 15 seconds, you know, I could have been there in a state of resistance. Like, you know, what the fuck is this woman just doing sitting there in the goddamn fucking car? Why don't you get out and fucking you know, that type, that would be a state of resistance. You know. Resistance is what it breeds negative emotions, or it can be the doorway to repressed emotions. Because, you know, all those emotions can just be going into the subconscious, just be sitting there kind of dormant. And if we don't learn how to deal with them, or to deal with them right there in that moment, then they go into our body and they're a weight being to be dealt with. And if we don't deal with them in a timely manner, well, they'll just sit in the body. This is what causes the body to start the decay process from the inside out. And eventually eventually the body dies. But that's another subject on how to live forever. It's called dealing with repressed emotions. This is the key to living forever, as well as the projection and expectation of our thoughts. So getting back to my moment of feeling good, you know, looking back at everything, I was able to maintain a pretty damn good moment by moment, just feeling good moment by moment for those 15 seconds, considering the situation that I was in and how I explained it. Now, when we finally got done talking, you know, she finally asked, and I says, yeah, are you serving dinner tonight? And she kind of paused for a minute. And, you know, for like 3 seconds or so. And instantly I picked up in my mind that she connected with the word serve. Whenever you serve anybody in the system that we live in, you're talking about being served legal papers, being summoned to court. And I instantly picked up on that. But she interpreted that word serve as being served court papers. For whatever reason, she was thinking, you know, she had her own thoughts based on that. I could tell that it jarred her for 3 seconds. Just the mention of that word serve was bringing all kinds of emotions and thoughts into her own mind. Who knows what's going on in her life that she would meet someone back there that mentioned the word serve to her that clicked this barrage of information in her mind. Who knows what she's going through. But even that can be sought out and figured out and deciphered. So, anyway, but getting back to everything, you know, I was following this path of feeling good because my intention was to just sit there and feel good, and I'm in a moment of wait and anticipation for her to get out of the car so that I can ask her the question, you know, are you serving tonight? But she finally got out, and I could tell by the strain and the tone in her voice when she answered me, you know, she was very uncomfortable, you know, having some dirty streeter dude in dirty streeter clothes on his 10-speed. And I had my robber's cap on to keep my head warm. It was all just kind of thrown on there at a funny angle and kind of looking like I was from, you know, some mean neighborhood or something, or who knows what she saw in me, but I could sense it. She was looking at me like I was a threat, a streeter dude threat, you know, dirty looking, robber looking, you know, who knows, I have a beard and everything, who knows, I have an older presence about myself, so I'm much more wiser, schemier probably, in her eyes, but so I was sensing all this as I was waiting for her to answer my question for that 2 seconds, and she finally did. You know, I told her, you know, I haven't been here for a year. It's been a year since I've been here, and you know, I was still serving. And she finally said, I don't know. And I looked, that was her kind of a thing. It was kind of strained on her behalf, because she didn't really, like I said, she's feeling comfortable. But yet, you know, getting back to the subject of this vid, you know, feeling good moment by moment. You know, I'm sitting there and I'm doing my best to just ask the minimal amount of questions and spend the minimal amount of time as I can in her presence so that I can feel good. Because I know that if I was to break the threshold and just kind of sit back there and question her and question her and question her and question her, pretty soon I'm going to start not feeling very good because my conscience is telling me that, you know, I'm bringing a lot of resistance and strain into this encounter with this particular person who happened to be a woman around the same age that I am. And so, you know, she finally answered my question and said, no, she doesn't know. And then as I was glass again. I said, oh, I see some people up front. I'm going to go ask them. And so that was it. So I left. Everything was kind of a, it was in my, I was trying very hard to make sure I was going to feel good in that moment. I remember that, at least, although it was unconscious. But looking back at it, I could see part of it was conscious. I was trying to feel good, make it the most best encounter, close encounter, invasion of her privacy that I could. And so I moseyed up to the front, and I went to the front, and there was a guy there hauling a desk into the front of the church, the glass doors, and he was getting to the point where he was against the door, so I wrote a little quickly, and got closer to him, and I said out of desperation, hey, are you serving food tonight? And next thing you know, another woman pops out. Also has the same color of hair. It almost kind of looks like the same woman I was just talking to. But she pops out. And I thought to myself, damn, this is the same woman I was just talking to? It's the same woman. Did she just walk from the back door down the hallway up to the front already? By the time I rode around the side of the building to the front? And it took me about 15-20 seconds to do that. But she could have done that. But I was just kind of amazed, but yet at the same time, she did look a little different. And so I asked her, are you serving tonight? And I could sense that she too was totally on her guard. And she had the door, front door was open, and she had her arm on that door cocked like she had her hand on a gun. In other words, she was ready to slam that door shut if I was to charge her for any reason. I tried to break into the church and rob her or something. There I am, a streeter dude, and I purposely put on my dirty clothes that day for certain reasons. I do that on purpose to go undercover out to the public, because I like to experiment with the public and this and that. And so, you know, I was making sure, you know, just to concentrate on feeling good and make it the most pleasant thing I could. And she finally said, well, they're serving on Friday evenings. I said, oh, at 5:45 still? She says, 5:30. And I was wanting to get a little more specific. Well, was it 5 or 5:30? And I thought, well, she's had enough of me. She can't. I'm breaking her threshold if I was to ask her pinpoint another question. So I decided to stay with what felt good. See, that's the point. I could have took it into another realm. I could have stayed there another couple seconds. Fractions of seconds is all it takes for the mind to go into not feeling good anymore. So all we have to do is just, you know, feel like we're stepping on someone's toes, or if someone's person that we're talking to, if they feel that their toes are being stepped on for a fraction of a second, that's all it takes, and all of a sudden they start emitting an aura about themselves, and it's a nasty, yucky, shitty aura, and it can just splatter all over us as we're sitting there talking. And so I made sure to avoid that as much as I could, so I did not ask her another pinpointing question. I just figured to myself, well, 5:30, show up at 5 and wait half hour if I have to. And so, and then I made sure that I wanted to make her feel good as best as possible, but mainly for the sake of making myself feel good. I said, oh, thank you very much, thank you. And I smiled and I quickly left. And of course, she didn't smile or nothing like that. She was happy for my ass to get out of there. Because for all I know, she was ready for me to throw punch number two, and that was, can I have a dollar? Because that's another very uncomfortable situation for church folk. And so I left, and I purposely was able to make myself feel good, so that I left that whole situation with that church between interaction with Close Encounters, Invasion of Privacy with these women, these two women. And I left totally clear conscience. I did have no repressed emotions about it whatsoever when I left. So, you know, repressed emotions would have been emotions such as, you know, this thing's pissing me off. Bitch, fucking stupid ass. All those, and it's not that, just could have been confusion, it could have been all kinds of directions, and all those emotions I would have, all these thoughts, every thought has an emotion attached to it, and we take that whole set of emotions that can be repressed, and they're not feeling good emotions, they're repressed emotions, they go deep down into the mind, the brain, and they settle, and they sink. If we don't deal with those, like if I would have been riding off on my bike, I didn't deal with those emotions. I just kind of like put up my wall of pride, you know, just prided my way through the emotions. And all those feelings would have sunk down into the ocean of the body, down to the bottom of the ocean, and just sat down there and started rotting and rotting for years and years and years and years and years. So, kind of opens up your mind as to all your life's encounters that you've gone through. You think about yourself, all your encounters that you've had with people that you've never dealt with, or with the emotions, and come clean on them. Think of all those emotions that are sitting in your bottom of your ocean, just rotting, rotting, putrefying. All those years and years and years and years.
So,
mainly, this was an expression video on how to feel good moment by moment. So I think I did a pretty good damn good job. So, right, as soon as YouTube gets back up online, I'm going to upload this video.